circumference, in fact, is made up of arcs. For example, the circumference of this circle is made up of arcs BQ, QR, RS, and SP. In other words, if we add up the lengths of all these arcs, we get the circumference of the circle. When an arc of a circle is bounded by two radii, they form regions called sectors. The smaller sector, which is lesser than a semicircle, is called minor sector, and its corresponding arc is the minor arc. The larger sector, which is greater than a semicircle, is called major sector, and its corresponding arc is the major arc. Similarly, when an arc of a circle is bounded by a chord, the region between the chord and the arc is called a segment. The smaller segment, which is less than a semicircle, is the minor segment, and the larger segment, which is greater than a semicircle, is the major segment. Let's learn how to find the length of an arc. The area of a sector and the area of a segment. This is a circle with center O and radius OC, which also equals OD. Angle COD is the angle made at the center by the arc CXD. We know that the angle made at the center by an arc is the degree measure of the arc. Now, let's draw another circle with center O, but radius less than OC. We name the arc as BYQ. Notice that the angle made at the center by the arc BYQ is angle COD. So the angles made at the center by the arcs BYQ and CXD are the same. Now, let's say we cut these two arcs and compare their lengths. As you can see, the lengths are not equal. So, even though the degree measures of both arcs, that is, the angles made at the center by the two arcs were the same, their lengths differ. How can we then find the length of an arc? Let's find out. Let's consider the circumference of a circle to be C units. Thus, the circumference is an arc of length C units, and the arc makes an angle of 360 degrees at the center. Now, we divide the circle into two semicircles. So, the length of the arc is half the circumference of the circle, and the angle made by the arc at the center is 180 degrees. Let's take the ratio of the length of the arc to the circumference of the circle, and the ratio of the angle of the arc to 360 degrees. As you can see, the ratios are the same. Next, here is a quadrant of a circle. The length of the arc is now 1/4 of the circumference of the circle, and the angle made by the arc at the center is 90 degrees. Once again, we take the ratio of the length of the arc to the circumference of the circle, and the ratio of the angle of the arc made at the center to 360 degrees. Notice that both ratios are the same. Similarly, when the length of the arc is 1/8 of the circumference of the circle, the angle made by the arc at the center is 45 degrees, which is 1/8 of 360 degrees. Thus, the ratios are the same again. So, the ratio of the length of the arc to the circumference of the circle is equal to the ratio of the angle made by the arc at the center of the circle, which is represented by theta, to 360 degrees. Thus, the length of the arc is theta over 360 times the circumference of the circle. Now, if we know the angle made by the arc at the center and the radius of the circle, we can find the length of the arc by applying the formula. We substitute theta with the measure of the angle made by the arc at the center and put in the value of the radius of the circle. Then we simplify and thus find the length of the arc. Now, if you know the length of the arc and radius of the circle, can you find the measure of the angle of the arc made at the center? We've seen that the length of an arc is a fraction of the circumference. In the same way, the area of a sector is a fraction of the area of a circle. Let's consider the area of a circle to be a square unit. Let's see if the ratio of the area of a sector to the area of a circle is equal to the ratio of the angle of the sector to 360 degrees. When the sector is a semicircle, the area is half of the area of a circle, and the angle made at center is half of 360 degrees, which is 180 degrees. As you can see, the ratio of the area of the sector to the area of the circle is the same as the ratio of the angle of the sector to 360 degrees. Next, this sector is a quadrant and its area is 1/4 of the area of the circle. The angle of the sector is 90 degrees. Again, you can see that the ratios are equal. Similarly, when the sector is 1/8 of the area of the circle, the angle of the sector is 45 degrees, which is 1/8 of 360 degrees. The ratios become equal again. Therefore, the ratio of area of sector to the area of the circle is equal to the ratio of the angle of sector, represented by theta, to 360 degrees. Thus, we get the area of a sector is equal to theta over 360 times the area of the circle. Let's look at an example. A sector makes an angle of 135 degrees at the center of the circle. The radius of the circle is 7 centimeters. Find the area of the minor sector. We use the formula theta over 360 times the area of the circle. We put in the measure of the angle at the center and the value of the radius and simplify. Thus, we get the area of the required sector. The area of a sector and the radius of the circle are given. Find the angle of the sector. In this circle, AB is a chord. Let's see how to find the area of the segments formed by the chord. We'll join OA and OB. Observe that OA and OB are the radii and they form a sector along with the arc APB. Notice that the area of the minor segment of the circle is equal to the difference between area of the minor sector OABB and area of triangle OAB. Similarly, the area of the major segment is equal to the sum of the area of the major sector OAQB and area of triangle OAB. Let's take the radius of this circle to be 6 centimeters. Length of chord AB is 6 times the square root of 3 centimeters. And the angle subtended by the chord is 120 degrees. Now, to find the area of a segment, we need to know the area of the sector and triangle OAB. We know how to find the area of the sector using the formula. However, to find the area of triangle OAB, we need to know the height. So, we draw a perpendicular OC to the chord AB. Now, in triangles OAC and OBC, AC and CB are equal because a perpendicular drawn from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. OA and OB are equal because they are radii of the same circle. Also, by construction, angles OCA and OCB are right angles. Thus, triangles OAC and OBC are congruent by right angle hypotenuse side congruence. Now, angles AOC and BOC are equal to each other as they are congruent parts of congruent triangles. Triangle OAC is a right angle triangle with angle AOC as 60 degrees. As the sum of the measures of all angles in a triangle is 180 degrees, the measure of an angle OAC is 30 degrees. Using trigonometric ratios, we find the length of OC, which is the height of the triangle OAB. So, to find the area of the minor segment, we put in the formulae for area of sector and area of triangle. We then substitute the values and simplify. Thus, we find the area of the minor segment. Similarly, let's find the area of the major segment by adding the area of the major sector and triangle OAB. To find the angle made by the major sector AQB, we subtract the measure of the angle made by the minor sector from 360 degrees. Next, we put in the values in the formulae for area of sector and area of triangle. Then we simplify and thus find the area of the major segment.